Catamount Connection rolls on. We are now with the head coach of the women's hockey team, Jim Plumer, to catch up on his squad and what he's up to. So, Coach, how are you? Where are you? What's going on in your world right now?
Well, I'm safely at home in Williston, Vermont here. I have a desk here right off my kitchen, and, you know, part of my routine is 8 o'clock a.m. I'm at the desk. And so that's I really try to stick to that to have a work mindset while I'm home.
So how much are you talking to the team throughout all this? Is it daily, weekly? How do you keep up with your student athletes?
Well, we're, you know, I'm really trying to reach out individually to kids on a regular basis, just to touch base, just texting and stuff like that, and some calls. We've had formal meetings. We did our end of the season meetings with a video on video. With at least one other coach and myself the week before last. So that was 5 or 6 hours a day of staring at the computer and being on the meetings. Right now we're doing a team meeting once a week, on Tuesdays. And, my approach to it, beyond the obvious, trying to make sure everybody's safe and constantly asking people if they know anybody or have any connection to anybody who's sick, is, I really just kind of looked at it like, okay, so we're not doing what we'd normally do here by being on campus and training. And let's not let this opportunity go by to grow in some different way. So we're taking this opportunity with our team to redefine and re-explore our core values and further our culture. And it's been awesome. Honestly, I think that we wouldn't have had the time for these kinds of meetings and these kinds of discussions if we were on campus. So I look at it actually as a kind of hidden benefit.
So I heard that to keep busy, one of your things is motivational books and speakers. Can you give us a little insight into that and what people should be checking out when it's probably pretty tough to stay motivated right now?
Well, that's true. I mean, there's so much stuff on social media right now. And there's, you know, there's John Gordon and the things that he does. And he just had a Power of Positivity Summit that I know a couple of our players were following. We are going to be doing some projects pretty soon here. One of our favorites is Inky Johnson. I don't know if you're familiar with him, but he's a former football player who had a tragic accident and has become a guy that really talks about making the most of opportunities and overcoming adversity. And so, it's funny that you would ask, because I haven't really revealed some of our future plans to incorporate some of that stuff in. But one of the things that's really nice is we have kids that are really interested in a lot of different things, and some that are really interested in sports psychology and ask for things and ask for books. Or, do you have any recommendations? And, you know, the kids are definitely feeling like they have more time being away. They don't have their time to hang out with their friends or their social time that they would normally have. And they're still pretty busy with their schoolwork. But I think, you know, again, I've approached it like, okay, well, how can we use this time to grow? And there's the individual growth, and then there's the team growth. And they've really embraced that. And we just literally just had a call, and it's so much fun to see everybody together. I think they're happy to see everybody on the same screen, and we get some chuckles in there as well.
So Sarah Dalton brought her dog on camera a couple of weeks ago. Do you have any pets? Are they around right now?
I do have two pets, and unfortunately they're not here right now. And they're prone to, I'm sitting here in my, you know, in my home office, and next thing you know, Hazel, who's our rescue dog, little brown dog, pops up on the screen, starts giving me kisses. I think the thing that might be good right now about the dogs not being here is we also have a husky. Chowder is his name, and he likes to howl, and I think they're both a little out of sorts, like, Dad, how come you're not going to work and we're getting locked in the bedroom and sleeping all day, even though they're laying around sleeping? And so Chowder has taken to howling, I want to say, like, on average about 6 times a day, which is really loud. Oof. and Hazel joins in. She thinks that she's trying to be a husky too, like her big brother. And so it can be a little distracting when you're on a call and all of a sudden I just have to hit the mute button, or before I wasn't hit. The people on the call generally think it's amusing. I think it's less amusing. My neighbors probably think it's even less amusing than that.
Yeah, that's a good point. You can't really mute it for your neighbors. Yeah. So I guess for audio's sake, we're happy they're not here. But of course, anything you want to get in for folks watching before we let you go?
No, I know you asked me, like, what I'm doing with what I'm watching on TV. I'm sure everybody's binge watching something. I'm unusual in that my girlfriend is working full time still. She's a physical therapist that works at a rehab facility, an inpatient facility down in central Vermont. So I'm pretty much approaching the workday normally. But we are binging on Grey's Anatomy of all things. Never watched it. She started watching it during the season when I was gone, and I've kind of gotten hooked. But yeah, 24 episodes per season, 16 seasons. We got a ways to go, but we're into season 9. We're into season 9, but it's pretty good. It's much better than I ever realized. I had not even sure I had ever watched a single episode. But
all right, cool. Well, Jim Plumer's recommendation, throw it back to Grey's Anatomy. I like that. Coach, thanks so much for doing this, and good luck with the rest of this offseason.
Thanks, Mike. Appreciate it, and stay safe.